Welcome to Electro Online, and another very interesting topic that has to do with the effect of magnetic fields on moving charges or currents is called the Hall effect. With this ingenious concept, Hall was able to determine the sign of the charges moving through a conductor. He was able to determine that the charges are actually negative charges moving through the conductor through this experiment. So here, let's set up a theoretical model here. Let's say we have a conductor made out of some conducting material. Let's say there's a certain amount of thickness to the plate and a certain amount of height h. Let's call the thickness equal to x, I guess. So the thickness x, height h. And let's say that there's current moving from left to right. Let's say that the charges are positive. And also let's say that we have a magnetic field perpendicular to the conductor. The amount of current flowing through the conductor is I, and the, let's see here. And I guess that's all we need to know. All right, now, next is the current density. By definition, current density is equal to the current flowing through the conductor divided by the cross-section area, which in this case is x times h. Also notice that the current is proportional or equal to, in this case, the charge density, the number of charges per unit volume, times the size of each charge, which here we assume to be a single charge, times the drift velocity, times the cross-sectional area. Which means that if we want to define the current density J, that is equal to I divided by the area, which is equal to simply NQ times the drift velocity. Now, what are the charges present here? I mean, the forces present. Well, if there's a magnetic field moving from left to, if there's a magnetic field moving perpendicular, or not moving, but situated perpendicular to the conductor, and there's charges moving in this direction, notice if the charges are moving in this direction, they're positive charges, so we use our right hand, and the magnetic field is into the board, that means the force experienced is going to be upward, which is drawn right there, and so positive charges would tend to drift towards the top of the conductor, and therefore there'd be an excess of negative charge at the bottom, so there's a separation of charge here. That separation of charge will set up an electric field. So we'll have an electric field then from top to bottom in this direction, all the way through this conductor, and this will be present everywhere like that. And so what then happens is we can then equate the velocity to the strength of the electric field and to the strength of the B field. Let's see how we can do that. Well, first of all, the effect of the magnetic field, the force of the magnetic field on the moving charge is as follows. Force is equal to QVB, and then we also know that the force caused by an electric field on the charged particle can also be written as Q times the strength of the electric field. So we know that those two forces must be equal, so the force of the magnetic field must be equal to the force caused by the electric field, so therefore we can equate those two equal to each other, so we can say that QVB must therefore equal to Q times E. Notice that the Q's cancel on both sides, so we know that the velocity of the charges in there are equal to E divided by B, which is actually interesting when you think about it. That's the same equation that we find in a velocity selector. And then, of course, is the drift velocity of the charges moving through the conductor. So, if we now want to compare seek out the number of charges that are moving to the top of this conductor in this Hall effect, how do we do that? Well, we know that the current is NQVD times the cross-sectional area. So there's a relationship between this V right there, this is the drift velocity, and this V right there. So let's write that equation down. We know that the current I is equal to NQV drift times cross-sectional area. And we know that the drift velocity can also be written as E divided by B. So I is equal to N times Q times E divided by B, the electric field strength divided by the magnetic field strength times area. Now notice the magnetic field strength is something we know because we apply a certain magnetic field with a certain known strength to that conductor. The electric field can be found by knowing that the electric field can be defined by the potential difference divided by the distance. The distance here will be h, and the potential difference is simply something we can measure. We can put two probes on here and measure the potential difference between the top and the bottom of the conductor. So this can be measured to be V between A and B, the top and the bottom, divided by h, which is the height of the conductor, or the distance between one end and the other end. So those are two measurable values. We can assume the charge to be a single unitary charge, and we can measure the cross-sectional area, so therefore we can see that N, the number of charges per unit volume that move to the top of this due to the Hall effect, is going to be equal to, we have I times B divided by, see here we have I and B to the top, N, Q, E, and A, so we have N, Q, E, and A to the bottom. And of course, we could then say that the current density is I divided by A, so we could say that the number of charges per unit volume that move to the top can be expressed in terms of the current density times the magnetic field divided by the size of each charge times the electric field. And that's how Hall determined two ways. One, that the charges, he could determine the type of charge that are moving to the conductor depending upon how the potential difference is set up. For example, if these were negative charges, they would then be moving to the bottom, and so you get this differentiation like that. Let's see here. Negative charges, B field, negative charges moving this way. So yeah, the negative charges would be moving this way, positive charges would be moving that way. So we have the current density times the magnetic field divided by Q times E. B is measurable, E is measurable, J is also measurable, Q is known, and so therefore we can calculate the number of charges moving up and down in the conductor due to the Hall effect. That's what Hall did. Pretty clever again.